progress. It has to be a continuous effort, and the best way to go forward is really following a standard and tailoring it to meet the basic needs of the
organization. The challenge is huge, it's highest, and we have to, rather than working in silos, we have to work collectively for this challenge and to address it. And forum like this contribute a lot.
Okay, I would like to comment on the second point made by Zahir. I think there is a desperate need to have effective IS regulations in this country to start off with. And unless and you don't have that, you cannot actually have a proper IS culture everywhere. That thing needs to come from the top.
अब लेजिस्लेशन के कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी की बात ना यूनिवर्सल बिकॉज़ बहुत सारे सर कॉन्फिडेंशियलिटी रेजिम ही टॉक्ड अबाउट
बिल्कुल इसको बहुत सख्त जरूरत है और जब तक वो नहीं होगा हम लोग एक अच्छी मार्ग पर बैठ नहीं सकते.
अच्छा और एड करा रहा हूँ कि विदाउट द रेगुलेटर्स इन प्लेस इट वुड बी रियली डिफिकल्ट फॉर सीआईएसओस टू गेट थिंग्स मूविंग बिकॉज जैसा हमारा कल्चर है पाकिस्तानी कल्चर तो इधर Dunday ka zor hai, that's the only way things get working. So you cannot get things moving without the regulations. Matlab State Bank ki affiliation ke umbrella ke andar kuch banna padega forum aur uske baad hi started working with BCP when State Bank came matlab with the regulation ke it's a requirement. When it was do it or people weren't ready to go for a BCP or a complete DRP of their IT solutions and stuff like that.
I look at it at, in two perspectives actually. The one you are talking about is regulatory limits. Those are the organizational obligations. There are personal obligations of every individual, every professional, every citizen of the country in fact, for that matter. So we usually sit in these type of forums and talk about information security or the specific topics, but dissemination of this information is very limited. So whatever forum we are sitting in and we are discussing few topics, this should be disseminated to the larger audience. So one objective of these forums could be dissemination to maybe the upcoming next generation of professionals, which will bring in a cultural change which is required for IS implementation, effective IS implementation. So as Farooq said, he has planned for his organization the awareness session and has measured his effectiveness as well. So that needs to be done at a larger scale, I believe. And individuals sitting in forums like these should take the responsibility and go to maybe academia or to the forums or the student forums and talk about these things in general to bring in the change in the long term.
Yeah, I'll take this comment further. In a security flashback, I think you want like to think like a typical CISO who just thinks about his company. I think we need to give a weight over society, a society that has given us a lot. We need to give something to our country in the form of maybe highlighting the weak links in our governmental organizations where information security can be exposed and our country's image can be exposed. We need to educate our peers, our fellows, our friends about information security and create an environment which is more secure, more reliable, and which can carry the good image of itself.
I have a different worry, friends. जितनी भी थ्रेट्स की हम बातें कर रहे हैं अगले दो सालों में थ्रेट्स इससे घिरा पड़ रहे हैं. हम क्लाउड कंप्यूटिंग की बात कर रहे हैं, डाटा सेंटर्स की बात कर रहे हैं, नेटवर्क सेंट्रिक आईटी की बातें कर रहे हैं. जो कुछ मैं अब नए स्टैंडर्ड्स दुनिया में देख रहा हूँ तेजी के साथ, उसकी समझ बिल्कुल नहीं है. लेट वेट. तो बेसिक इशू नॉलेज का ही बन जाएगा. जहाँ तक हम आज तक समझ पाए हमें सिक्योरिटी को फ्रेंड, उससे कई रात फ्रेंड हमें अगले दो सालों में देखने पड़ेंगे. जो गेनी टेक्नोलॉजी की जो बातें हो रही हैं ये इनको उठा दें, उसके लिए हम क्या तैयारी करते हैं. मैं समझता हूँ फॉरन को उसके ऊपर काम करना पड़ेगा. दूसरी बात ये इंटरनेशनल लेवल के ऊपर हमारा बहुत पुअर इमेज है, ये मुझे जानते हैं कि इस बात को यकीन जानने बाहर के मुल्कों में सिवाय इनको या मुझे या एक दो आदमियों के पाकिस्तान में जानते हैं.
आपको समझ आदत होगी कि 8 साल तक मैं बाहर के तमाम सेमिनारों में एनआरसी से प्रेजेंट करता हूँ सर्ड फ्रेंड्स विच वॉज रॉन्ग लेकिन कोई प्रेजेंस नहीं है फोरम के ऊपर जबकि मैं इंडिया को देखता हूँ उसके 30 लोग आ रहे हैं अब ये सोचना पड़ेगा कैसे हमारे यंग लोग वहाँ जाए एंजॉय पाते हैं फॉर एग्जाम्पल ओआईसी सर्ट में हमने बहुत काम किया है अभी 28 अक्टूबर को उसका एनुअल फंक्शन है मैंने बहुत लोगों को रिक्वेस्ट किया कि जो अपलोड कर सकते हैं वो चले मेरे साथ करने की ताकि बताएं कि पाकिस्तान में क्या हो रहा है इसका तभी तो पता नहीं चलेगी थोड़ी सी और तीसरी आखिरी बात मैं कहना चाहूँगा कि हम सारी फोरम की बात करें फोरम रहने में कोई इंटरेस्ट नहीं भाई मैं पिछले 5-6 साल से पैसा बनाने की कोशिश कर रहा हूँ बस एक बात यह है कि प्रेजेंस भी होना चाहिए लोग कहते भी होना चाहिए यदि मुझे ज़्यादा कराची की है इस्लामाबाद में काफ़ी काम कर चुका हूँ फ्रेंड की लाहौर में बड़ी प्रॉब्लम आ रही है वो मैं जो रिक्वेस्ट की है कि कराची में प्लीज लीडरशिप को आगे लेकर आए ये कुछ और बनाने फोरम अगर पैसा नहीं पर एक फोरम बनना जरूरी है और वो फोरम जो है वो इतना स्ट्रांग हो हर हवाले से आप ये मे भी आप उसको डेढ़ बजे मीटिंग करने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं उसमें सजेशन दें कि उसकी क्या स्ट्रक्चर होता है में क्या उनका ऑफिस हो कैसे वो काम करे नेचुरली ये रिसोर्स में तो काम ही चल सकता है इसके ऊपर और रिसोर्स कहाँ से आएंगे गवर्नमेंट तो नहीं देगी मुझे उसके अलावा क्या सोचते हैं आप बिल्कुल सही कहा हमें रेगुलेटर्स को तमाम को आगे लाना पड़ेगा वरना काम नहीं चलेगा उसी फोरम के अंदर वो बने हुए हों ग्रुप बने हुए होंगे रेगुलेटर के साथ बात करनी है ये आरएनटी है ये एकेडमी से बात करनी है ये स्टूडेंट्स से बात करनी है उसी में जाहिर साहब को जो पॉइंट है एक सेटअप हो कि जी आप सिर्फ चैट रूम की बात करनी है तो बात करनी है
I think just to clarify my position I'm not saying don't be with government and keep them completely out I'm just saying there are different times for different roles so I was just drawing something here there's one silo where this is the private silo where information sharing takes place, standards are being built up by industry, awareness is taking place, perception management for Pakistan is taking place. I mean, that's your silo for the private sector within that, where government is not necessarily involved. And then the government sector, where this same entity, forum, group, whatever it is, communicates, disseminates, cooperates, etc., whatever, and with the government, which you know, the government's responsibilities and interaction with them would include legislation, so that there's an environment related to that. It will be dealing with enforcement, so then the FI would come into that segment. And then, you know, obviously, to give you a simple example, just cloud computing, something that came to mind, there's a state line called Pakistan outsourcing guideline, which says you cannot outsource anything via outside Pakistan, period, full stop. You have to do it locally, then you have to take permission. Cloud computing, what happens? So, you know, I mean, they have to be educated as well. So that would be the second side. So, I mean, I'm not proposing that you don't relegate them, don't talk about them. But, you know, everybody has a place. Industry has a place of its own. And then how industry talks to government, etc., interacts with them is a separate way to do it. That's all I'm saying.
Just have a small comment on what I was saying. So the thing is that last year we had a PISA meeting in Karachi Sheraton, and they were around 8 to 10 ISRs over there. And he made some commitments to you. We had already proposed a cert, okay. And I had committed that I will arrange for funding from banks as a CSR project. We just need endorsement, that's it. We are willing to set up a cert over there.
Thank you.
That's a personal commitment.
I think I agree with the most of the points people have made here that basically law regulations are important. It's important to bridge the gap between senior management and IS function. Then end user awareness is very important. Most importantly, I think information security should be a common individual process. And it can improve only through like knowledge sharing and then we can go back to our organization and implement the improving knowledge.
Well, I would conclude like technology is available. You know, we do have technology. We can deploy boxes. You know, that does not take much of the time. 2-3 days, you can deploy a firewall and all that. But to promote the real essence of information security, I believe we need to create awareness and promote IS in non-IS and IT people in your organization. You know, this is suggesting. So, second point, yes, rightly agree you as well, Kamran. And like, if we have that platform, we would definitely like to have some stats, you know, where our information security in numbers stand in Pakistan. You know, where does it stand? Where is it heading? How much potential is there in our market? You know, what are the areas we need to work on at the moment? All right, you know, regardless of what internationally is happening, but what is the condition of IS in Pakistan? What things we will be looking in next 3 years, 4 years, so down the line, and so we can, you know, keep ourselves updated and work accordingly.
By the way, locally, locally, we do smaller surveys almost every quarter. Those are, I think, available online also. But internationally, CSO does an annual State of the CSO survey.
Mm-hmm.
This was the first year that we pushed it out to the local community. Isabelle, Pakistan had never participated.
Mm-hmm.
And those results should be available sometime soon because they're so successful. But it was, they were somewhat happier because this was the first time that at least some members of the IS community had participated. And hopefully, as the awareness and issues become more prevalent and more CISOs have a little bit more time to spare, because it's a really long survey, we'll be able to do some more. So at least if you international, and locally, I think we can follow that and also push that.
And we definitely want to see, you know, more organizations coming up with best security standards implemented. You know, definitely, we would like that to be, you know, like as compared to your neighbors, like you can see a lot of banks there, you know, having international standards. We definitely would like our community, you know, Pakistan as well, to be there somewhere in the posture.
One challenge in our organization has been security awareness, especially in Pakistan. When we start conducting some of these security awareness trainings, one of the questions that does come up quite often is how much will it affect us in numbers? Mainly in, you know, in a dollar figure or a rupee figure. The problem is, I mean, Pakistan, we've been looking around, we have not been able to find proper stats. You know, if there's a breach in our organization, how much will it cost us? If you go overseas, because I spent a lot of time in North America, back a couple years back, maybe 10 years back, there weren't a whole lot of stats either. But government stepped in and created breach notification laws, and they're still creating them as we're going along. And so now organizations in North America have to notify the government agencies, the police, and the general public, whoever's affected, if there is a breach in their organization. So if, you know, some of you may remember the TJ Maxx incident or the Heartland payment systems incident, they were mandated by law in some of the states, as well as by PCI, to notify all their customers, to notify the government agencies that yes, they indeed did have a breach. This is how many records were exposed, and from that they were able to determine, okay, this is what it's going to cost us. And so there's general numbers out there in North America where you can say, okay, it costs about $200 per record if we had a breach. So from there, from, you know, when I'm conducting training overseas, you know, I can say, well, you know, this is how much it's going to cost us if there is a breach in our organization. But I can't do the same here in Pakistan. So I mean, if government steps in and creates laws that, or regulators, whoever it is, to say if there's a breach in your organization here, you have to report it to a certain agency, I think we would have much more accurate stats here that we could all end up using to bring more awareness to the Pakistani market, to say that there's a reason why we're doing information security here.
But that information's gotta be public so people can access it. Right?
Exactly. Yeah. And then in North America, a lot of that information is actually public.
Like the Enron scandal, I was at that time in the States, so all of the business schools, the IT audits, and those courses were made mandatory after the...
Yeah, it's SOX, it's the one. A lot of these different regulations did come out after.
Actually, we have the more experienced people here, so I just started my career with information security and looking out the comments from Farooq Saab, Amar Saab, and Sajjad Saab, the awareness thing. So the major thing which I have noticed since the past 8 months and so before that I was not even aware of information security. So the basic idea here is we should have something at the academic level, because like the developers, they don't know anything about the web security. They are just developing and they don't know about the web security. And the students, they don't know about the information security. So we have to have something in, from the university levels, at the academic levels, to create an awareness for the information security to the professionals themselves, so that our new generation can come up with the information security careers. They can come up with the information security awareness.
Good point, very good point.
Okay, talking about security, I think that there is no such organization if it says that it's 100% secure. So because when we are thinking of a solution, somebody has already implemented a solution somewhere. And if the solution is implemented, somebody is already trying to break it. So I think if I can compare security with something, I would compare it with a seed. Like if we plant it, we give it water, we tame it from day one to the end, it will grow up into a tree. So that's the way the security should beef up in our environment. So if our investment or ROI can only be justified if we have regulatory compliance are met, all the legislation is made, and we have also enforced that legislation in our company. Not only these two things, but also there is awareness for the employees who are working under you inside, and there is also awareness to the society outside that this is the method, or these are the things which we should cater. When I talk about the public, I think that the public is not like me and you, it's like the governing bodies which are looking after these security issues, and that's how we can come up to a certain standard and make a level, good level of security.
Can I make a short comment on that? You're absolutely right. So let's look at the electronic transaction protocols of 2002. It requires that you keep secure your records in a certain form. Most people you talk to in box and say, well, what does that mean? Do you know that there's a requirement? They won't know about it, one. Second, it says that if you're going to do transactions between yourself and another organization, you should have a digital signature, otherwise the other party can computer and say this never happened. How many organizations do we actually see where this is a security issue? Because obviously that would be too risky. Just wanted to make this true. So that sometimes the laws do come in. You're absolutely right, we need more. Sometimes the laws do come in, but they don't get implemented into the security structure. They may not be seen as a security issue within a certain organization. I just want to make that short comment.
Right. So I think it's on the seat today. We should keep that around and CSO for organizing this, and we should keep watering and giving sunlight to this
seed.
Yes. The new grown plant, and let's see it growing. Thank you.
I think one last, from the discussion we had, I think one thing is very clear that information security is not a technical subject. I think today we saw, with thanks to Zahir, there are legal dimensions. We also saw that there's a business dimension very close. Unless you make it a business case, it will not. Human side, everybody talked about, society, the social engineering, awareness. So I think you have to see, information technology in totality. And secondly, I think we should not see that the situation in Pakistan is bleak. I do not see it that way. I think we have come a long way in the last 4 or 5 years. And obviously, I think some people have done a lot, Zahid and Amarsa, and maybe certain other people. We have, ETO and things like that, and still we are talking about certain other, the legislation, and So we have come a long way. And the younger generation that we see here, I think there is a lot of potential. This is a very niche area, specialized area, and to export, this market, this expertise or knowledge outside Pakistan, I see a lot of potential. Right now, rightly pointed out, it's awareness. We lack awareness, but wherever we have this capability, I think this is top notch, world class. These people can stand in front of some of the best people in this industry. We have that,
So I think it's, and obviously there is an evolution, you know. The state of IT industry in Pakistan is maturing, you know. What it was 10 years back, now you see, it's at a different level. Pasha 10 years back, Pasha now, it's different. Similarly, PISA or, you know, professional bodies, I think it's the evolution, it's the maturity, it will take time. And there will be disappointments, frustrations as we go along. But I think at least I have not lost hope. I see a lot of bright future for this particular segment within the country and more so outside Pakistan. I think this is...
If from where we started, 1999, when it was America, I think you have a feeling that you have to do something. You have to do something. You have to do something. वही नाम रखा है नेशनल रिस्पॉन्सिबल साइबर क्राइम होना चाहिए वो ये वो तो होता डॉक्टर होता है उसको होता होता है मुझे किसी ने पूछा ही नहीं कि वो नोट क्या होता है मैं चेस करता था तो खैर मुझे डॉक्टर होता है बुलाया उन्होंने एक्सप्लेन किया कि ये होना चाहिए इंटरनेट पे इसको कहाँ पर साइड होना चाहिए फिर वो वेरीफाई हो गई चार महीने के बाद मुझे एक फोन आया मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ आईटी से एसओ साहब आप करा मार जा फिर मैंने कहा ये साइबर सिक्योरिटी क्या होता है दो साल खामोश रहा फिर दो महीने फैले में आया तो मेरे कहा नहीं यार इसे बढ़ना चाहिए इसके फिर मैं बना तो आप ये देखिए राइट हमने यहाँ स्टार्ट किया है हमारे को बात सुनने को ध्यान नहीं जहां जहां छोड़ डाला इसके ऊपर आज तो मैं बड़ा कल से मैं इतना खुश हुआ कि इतने लोग रेलिवेंट लोग बात कर रहे हैं इसके ऊपर ये तो हमारा ख्वाब था यकीन करेंगे लोग इस तरह फिक्स फोकस लोग बैठ के बात करें देखिए इस कमरे में कोई आदमी नहीं है जो अनकंसर्न है इस चीज के साथ कमरों का पैसा जरूर है दुख जरूर है यार ये होना चाहिए और सर रमेश साहब ने कहा यकीन करें आप यंग लोगों में बड़ा ट्रस्ट है यकीन है हमने तो बड़े फर्स्ट आदमी बातें शुरू की थी जब लगी और आज तो हम बड़े आराम से बैठे हैं कि यार इन चीज़ों पर डिस्कशन हो रही है तो इसको लेके आगे चलने वाली बात है
नहीं बिल्कुल सर सर सो जस्ट टू कंक्लूड आई मीन आई थिंक वी हैड एन एक्सेलेंट डिस्कशन एंड थैंक्स टू द सीआईओ फॉर कंडक्टिंग दिस एज वेल एंड द की टेक अवे आई गेट फ्रॉम दिस वन एज वेल दैट आई विल स्टार्ट विद द सेम कमेंट आई मेड यस्टरडे आई डोंट सी इट एज अ रेवोल्यूशन इट्स एन एवोल्यूशन लाइक कमांड्स हैव आल्सो सेड कि जी हमें ये नहीं देखना चाहिए कि जी अभी क्या नहीं हो रहा बल्कि कि वो कहाँ से स्टार्ट किया था एंड वेयर वी स्टैंड टुडे लाइक व्हेन आई मूव बैक टू पाकिस्तान एज वेल एट दैट टाइम नोबडी वाज विलिंग टू लिसन टू ऑल द चेंज वाज लाइक कि जी अब क्या बातें कर रहे हैं एंड टुडे वी हैव सो मेनी पीपल हु आर एक्सपर्ट हु आर हैव ऑथेंटिसिटी इन व्हाट दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एंड हु हैज लोकल एग्जांपल्स सो व्हाट आई रियली सी इज इट्स अ मैटर ऑफ वन थिंग इज नॉलेज शेयरिंग which has come very strongly that it is about to share that knowledge that okay because there are banks, there are organizations who has locally done things internally. So we don't need to look outside in the US may and North America may kisi aur jagah pe kya ho raha hai. We can find good examples, find examples internally. But it's a matter of that knowledge sharing which we need to increase through these forums and through other ways. It is about that awareness you need to spread out instead of just confining it to few people that yes, as a social engineering matter, that maybe we need to start talking about security as well, as a social engineering thing. Yes, do you know what are the concerns or what are the things which can happen? And with all this, I see that we have to start talking about business cases or return on investment. As you said, I mean, like the more people will talk about it, the lesser we have to put efforts into justifying what it's really all about. So with that, thank you very much for the very productive discussion. And thanks, Javier, for connecting.
Great. Thank you very much for this.